Still to come, we'll talk with New Zealand First Leader Winston Peters. But first, he's renowned internationally in the world of dance music, but he's still a bit of a mystery to the Pacific community. He's Tongan, and like other international stars, he's known only by one name, Suwani.
My name is Suwani. I'm a DJ and producer from Auckland by way of Tonga. When I was working at the Box, they kind of pioneered the whole house scene, basically, in New Zealand. That's what I believe anyway. And, you know, I was standing there and this new music, this new sound was coming through, and I kind of, it took my ear. And people that I hung out with that, you know, were, that lived the hip-hop life and that thought I was a bit weird. You kind of have to sort of believe in what your judgment call to, you know, and nowadays, you know, I get a lot of the brothers that were staunch on not liking it, they all come to the gigs now, to my gigs, and, you know, they're like, yeah, man, it's all good. I usually have a couple of days set aside where I'm in the studio working. I DJ in the weekends. At the moment, I'm sort of opened myself up to going back and doing stuff in Australia again. And once a year, I head up to the north of England, to Manchester, and stay there for 6 to 8 weeks. And they send me off to, you know, London and various other places to DJ, and then I work in the studio during the week.
We asked them if he could give us a sample of those studio skills on a familiar tune. Still though, for the Tongan Prince of House, the clubs remained the buzz.
I headlined for Paper Recordings in Manchester at their Robo Disco Night. And it's their club night that they do once a month. And I had, you know, one of their best DJs kind of warming up for me, and that was a bit of a buzz, you know. As far as the house DJs are concerned, I've worked with some well-noted English DJs, Miles Holway and Elliot Eastwick, collaborated with them, and Dick Johnson, who lives here now, he's a really good friend of mine. And mainly English guys. I haven't quite yet worked my way into the American scene yet, but, you know, there's the pipe dream there. For me, I think the next progression for a DJ is, as far as being recognised as a musician, is producing your own stuff, you know, and working in the studio and getting that's, as far as your own stuff is concerned, that's your own personal voice, you know, because you're playing predominantly other people's work, and getting some sort of credibility from playing other people's music. So in order to sort of give back a little bit, you've got to make your own stuff, I reckon.
That's one well-travelled Tongan.